Well, it's October already. We've already had a very active hurricane season so far, and there's more left to come. This year, we've had a very good example of why tropical systems are so important in determining the moisture situation in Virginia. The month of August was on the verge of setting all-time records for dryness across the state. But tropical systems in late August and early September brought a welcome relief to many areas and helped to alleviate a number of water supply problems which were developing during the heat of summer. Unfortunately, the very dry period had already caused a great deal of crop damage that couldn't be erased even with this rainfall. Several factors have contributed to the large number of storms we've had this year. One is that the water temperatures in the Atlantic Basin have been running well above normal. This gives more fuel to these storms. We've also had a lack of El Nino conditions in the Pacific Ocean. This has created better upper air conditions for the formation of these storms. And we also seem to be entering a period of time in which we can generally expect to see more of these storms. When we look at the long-term history of hurricanes, we see that they generally tend to cycle up and down every few decades. According to this, we seem to be entering a period of time when we could look forward to increased tropical activity. This may not be all bad news. In the next 20 to 40 years or so, we could be in a situation where we may see more beneficial rainfall in Virginia at a time when we need it the most. And I'm Jerry Stenger with the Climatology Office at the University of Virginia, wishing you a very pleasant fall.